Yes, sesle rahat Gunjan.
Yep, hello, Bongani.
Ngiyaphila, do you consent that I record this call with an intention of uploading it on SA Infotainment podcast?
Yes, Bongani, we can continue recording. You have my permission.
All right. Last time we spoke, Advocate Defo was yet to appear for a pre-trial. And also, we briefly spoke about legal fees. I want us to talk about that and possibly the new development as to what are we going to ha what is going to happen now as we trying to or as we now have a lawyer on this issue. What is going to happen going forward? So let's start with an update about or concerning Advocate Defo. Did they meet? Was there pre-trial? What happened?
Oh, okay, Bongani. You will remember that the last time I had an update interview with you, we were kind of making a clarity to the people out there when it comes to whether he's out or not and what has been happening. And I said that no, he's not out. He's still in Sun City. He's still in detention, of which he is still there as we speak. People must not be confused. So what happened from there, I ended up getting an update that the case was postponed to yesterday. Which day? What is the date? What was the date in
Yesterday
season?
was the 19th of September 2024.
Yes. So with the previous appearance, the new attorney got on record and then she had to apply for the charge sheet so that she can know what he's been charged for, and then she can get the file so that she can start familiarizing herself with the case so that she can prepare to defend him. So what happened was it took about a week, I think, if not 2 weeks, for her to be able to get that, and she ended up getting everything that she was supposed to get yesterday on the 19th of September. So she got the charges yesterday, she got all the documents, the files, what he's been charged with, and then everything. So now, from yesterday, the case was postponed to the 9th of October 2024, which is next month. So from now up until that time, she will be preparing her case. So what's going to happen on the 9th is a pre-trial. This is where they will set a date to start with the trial. It's not the start of the trial, it's a pre-trial. It's basically in simple form to speak about how when the trial will start and whatever they need to speak about. So the 9th of September, I mean October, is a pre-trial now, and then from there they're gonna set a date to start officially with the trial. So basically, my husband will go through the trial while he's in detention up until the case is finished.
All right, we are talking about a pre-trial here, but we look. If somebody will ask and say, "Wait a minute, didn't we say there are two cases? There's one in Pretoria, there's one in Joburg. So this pre-trial that Advocate Defo's wife is talking about, is it for which case? The one in Pretoria or the one in Joburg?" Somebody's asking himself or herself that question.
The case that we're talking about is the one that is in Joburg, the trespassing case, together with there's an assault charges and then crime injuria charges as well. So this is the Johannesburg case. The reason why he's in detention in Sun City. We are not talking about the Pretoria case at all.
Just to remind somebody about the Joburg case is the Joburg case is the one that they denied him bail on.
Yes,
It's the
that's the
one
one.
that is currently keeping him in prison right now.
Yes.
All right. No, it's fine. Oh, you wanted to say something before I ask you something?
No, I just wanted to emphasize that when it comes to the Pretoria case, remember, he's on bail.
Okay, okay.
Yes, now, he is on bail on that one.
Now, let's move to the other interesting part. And you remember last time we touched briefly on legal fees, right? Even though you might not have been, you might not be able to announce the actual figure that will be needed, but do you now have an idea as to how much is needed for the lawyer to take this case going forward, or continue not taking it going forward, but yeah, to continue with this case? Do you have an idea as to how much is needed?
When it comes to the legal fees, the attorney is charging 3,000 rand per appearance.
Okay.
So that will only, I cannot say this is how much he's charging for the whole case, because he charges per daily appearance. So if he's gonna, for example, appear 3 times only on this case, that means it will be probably 9,000 rand. But now, you know, you cannot predict what would happen. So far, she has been charging on a daily appearance, which is 3,000 rand.
And I must say to people, by the way, I spoke to some lawyers, right? I wouldn't mention their names. And you know, sometimes to get these lawyers appearing on your behalf, depending with the experience and in the years and whatever they need, the titles, that price can go up to 12,000, some 15,000, some 20,000, just a day. Yeah, so for me, it's a reasonable fee, very reasonable.
Yes, that's true, Bongani, it's true. We could have been paying much more than that. You know, she's a very understanding person, and I'm so grateful that she saw it that she really needs to assist. For her, it's not necessarily about the money. Yes, she needs to get the money because she needs to travel, she needs to go to court, she needs this, she needs that, but it's coming out of the goodness of her own heart that she needs to assist this, as challenging as it is to represent my husband. But she took it to herself that she is going to do this up to the end so that she sees him out of that prison.
Another thing as well that I think is worth mentioning is the challenges that she's facing in this case, and the fact that there's research to be done, and the fact that there's a bit of security when it comes to advocate. Therefore, really, I feel like the price that we're being charged is very reasonable, considering the things that also does look, that will happen in the background. I honestly feel like, yeah, no, the price is very reasonable.
That's true, Wangan.
All right. Now, speaking about the price, let's introduce the death element into this. Tell me something. We have came up with new ways of fundraising. Can you touch on that so you are on record?
Okay. I have somebody who has availed themselves to assist me with trying to raise funds. And then his name is Ubabu Yubet Mapumolo. He approached me about, it's been probably 2 months now, if I'm not mistaken. He approached me and he's been following the case. He's been following what has been happening with my husband and the interviews that I have been having with you. So he has availed himself to assist when it comes to raising the funds. And he created an account on Becker Buddy. I didn't know about this, by the way. He's the one who came up with the idea that this is what we can try and do to raise some funds to assisting with the legal fees and personally me at home as well. So he has created a Becker Buddy account, and then I'm sure that I don't want to speak too much about it because I don't know how it works. He knows how it works. So Bongani will have a conversation with him after me so that he can give it thoroughly on how it works, and those who are interested in putting money into the Becker Buddy, it's like crowdfunding, then they can do so. But then still again, those who still feel comfortable in sending money into my account that we've been putting out there all along, they can all still do that. So either way, however people feel comfortable into helping and assisting, it will be very much appreciated. So yes, there is a Becker Buddy account that has been opened on the Becker Buddy app website. So people can go there. He will come on with Bongani's he will make an interview with you. I'm just confirming that when it happens, people must not be confused. Okay, what is happening now? Who is this? Yes, I can confirm. His name is Ubabu Yubet Mapumulo, and then he will have an interview with you, Bongani, and then he will give more details on how to go about the Becker Buddy funding.
All right. Okay. No, it's fine. I think it's clear. So wait, I'm going to add him as soon as I'm done with you. I'm going to add him just now. And then you look, yeah, when I was a Puma Ganeyan. Now, as Kulumenga Lege, I'm hearing Gucci, we're going to be, people will can send money to you, to those who are comfortable, can then send the proof of payment to him so we can now follow up. Okay, now this is how much we have raised and how much is needed for this lawyer. And also, even if they are sending for you, they can, even if they are just one, they just want to help you. I've heard Uguti, people who are donating to your account can then assist. I mean, sorry, they can then send the proof of payment to him so there can be a structural way of going about this to those who are comfortable. Am I saying it correctly?
Yes, that's true, Bongani. He will give out a number where anybody who will be able to send me some money, they can also send their proof of payment to that number. But it's not forced. If a person doesn't feel comfortable with sharing that they've made a deposit into my account, they want to keep it to themselves, it's still okay. But then to those who would like to send the proof of payment so that we can have a record. Yes, I will always have a record. It's just that sometimes because it doesn't really show Ubuti the where is the money come from or the name of the person or what, but I will see on my side that, okay, this one is a donation money, because the people who are close to me that I know personally, I also know when they send me money that this person sent me money, because they will always also send me a proof of payment. So if I receive money that I don't know who the sender is, then I automatically know that it's money for donation. Unless if maybe a person decides to write a reference as donation money or something that will make me realize, Kuti, oh, this is a donation money, because some of them, they do that. Then I'm able to see, okay, this is somebody who wanted to assist. So, Ubaba Mapumulo, he will give out a number to where people can send a proof of payment so that we can also have, he can also, because he's assisting me, I need to be transparent, I need to be fair, so that whatever that he's doing, he's also motivated to see that whatever that we are doing, at least we are moving the positive that is happening. So this is just to keep record and to be transparent between each other who are working together to make sure that this happens, so that when he sees on his side that, okay, from my side, this is how much I've been getting, and then when it comes, if it's 2,000 rand, for example, the money that we have gathered, then we know, okay, is it possible that we can share this money for the legal fees or for your personal needs at home? Because to be honest, right now at this moment, I'm basically a person who needs to be responsible for my kids, everything here at home. My husband doesn't have an income where he is. I also don't have an income. I'm just trying to see how I can provide for my kids. So when the money comes in most cases, I have to use it. If someone sends me 200 rand right now, I probably have to buy electricity or to buy gas or to do this. So this is just to make sure that there's transparency and we can have a record of how much money we have received so far.
It's okay. Let's start here. Do you mind saying your account out loud? Do you mind saying your account out loud?
No, I don't mind at all.
Okay, let's say it very slow again.
Okay, just hold on for me.
No problem.
Okay, Mangani, my account number, as I have said before, it's with Capitec Bank. That is the one that I prefer for people to use. I think it's easy to use a Capitec. The account number is as follows, is 167-157-1744. I'm going to repeat the account number.
And
is...
Be a bit slow.
167-157-1744. It's 10 numbers. I'm going to repeat it again. The account number is 167-157-1744. The account is under my name. You'll see it will say Miss LP, therefore.
All right. Thank you very much for that. Let's go to the email address then. You must also send me the email address so I can pin it as well in the comment section. Tell me something. Do you mind if you have it? Can you say it out loud too?
Okay. And then the purpose of this, I wanted to mention this, giving out my email address. I realized that on the comment section, there's people who wanted other alternatives to can assist without sending money directly into my account because they probably don't have the access to do that or it can cost them more. So if it's in that case, they can also contact me through my email address, which is Lerato Tefo in small letters as one word. It's Lerato Tefo 9, which is number 9, at gmail.com. Lerato Tefo 9 at gmail.com.
Can you say it then a bit slow?
It's my name, Lerato, and my surname, Tefo 9. All as one word in small letters at gmail.com.
All right. Is there anything else you want to say?
No, there isn't really much, but as always, I will always have to thank the people out there who are in support of my family and my husband.
If you are not yet subscribed, what are you waiting for? Come on, good people, because to subscribe it is free, to like the video it is free, to comment in the comment section below it is free of charge, to click the notification bell it is free of charge, to share this video it is free of charge, to watch this video until the end it is free of charge. Also, good people, I mean, come on, to watch the ads It's free of charge, and that's how you financially contribute to this YouTube channel. Speaking about financially contribution to the channel, you can join, become a member of this YouTube channel from as little as 20 rand a month. You can also use the Super Thanks button. In case you don't want to do that, guys, there is a way where you can use my media company banking details to donate to the channel, and you know what I'm saying, will bring you more, and also guys want to buy more equipment. So the power is in your hands. Please do the honorable thing as we proceed.
Puthubert.
Hello.
Sawubona, kunjani?
Sikhona njani?
Ngiyaphila. Do you consent that I record this call with an intention of uploading it on YouTube?
Oh yes, certainly yes.
Okay. Bengikhuluma noSisi Lerato, advocate, Defo's wife. We spoke at length about a lot of things, and she confirmed that I will be talking to you about a new way of funding, and she confirmed a lot of things. So I want us to talk about all those things, provided you can. Let's talk about the funding. She made mention of a funding mechanism that she did say that Yena, she doesn't know much about it. You're the one that knows much about it. But she had confirmed that she concerns, and she is you and her, you know each other, you understand how these things are going to work and going forward. So I would have loved you to take us into confidence and explain this thing of, you call it back a party or what? Can you kindly explain that?
Yes. Let me first give a brief background before I get in that, so that people would know how do I feature in this whole matter. I've been very concerned about Advocate Defo, and we all understand and we all know now what has been transpiring around the case, as well as the irregularities of the state and stuff. So coming from an NGO background, who ran my anti-corruption campaigns in the past, I saw a need to come in and assist. That's when then I got in touch with Mrs. Defo in that regard. So I put together a fundraising mechanism. There is a backup body, which is a crowdfunding platform, where you can just open an account there, and then you market that and let the public donate for whatever cause you want to raise the funds for. Basically, backup body, you can get it on Google, or you can go to www.backupbody.co.za. When you get in there, and then it will take you through. There will be donations, there will be campaigns, and then you go to campaigns, and then you enter justice and security for Defo. Immediately when you get in there, you can then donate whatever amount you need to donate.
Okay. Okay, no, it's fine. She has already spoken about this thing, Guti. The lawyer is probably looking for this much a day. People already are aware of that. So which number, because she spoke about the fact that there is a number where if a person, for instance, wants to donate to Advocate Defo's wife, Sis Lerato, and then they want to send a proof of payment, she said that people will send that proof of payment to you so that we can follow up a look at these things and have a clear direction as to, okay, we are raising this much for the lawyer. Okay, also we are assisting them with the look of the Defo family as well. So which number can you give me, or can you say that number out loud? But don't be fast. Just.
Okay. This is the WhatsApp number, 08333 18683.
Say it again.
08333 186 83.
Okay, thank you very much. Say, tell me something. If a person were to say, "Hey, I don't have time to send this money to Lerato. Hey, you know what? Let me send it to you." Will you take that man?
Absolutely not. I don't want to take any money. All I'm doing is rendering my free services to help Mr. Tefo and his family. I do not want. That is why I've opted to open this bank back a buddy campaign, which, and she, Mrs. Tefo, is the direct beneficiary of that. It does not come to me. I'm just managing the crowd fund and the owner of the account, but the beneficiary is Mrs. Tefo. So I don't want to handle any fund at all. So I'm just rendering my services to be able to assist in having a structured campaign so that it can be more effective. And we do appreciate for those that donate to send in their proof of payments, just so that we can thank them later and have records of the people that donated and how much it was donated. So it's more for transparency and for accountability. Because when we deal with public funds, it is very good that we account for them, even though they are going to assist privately to Tefo's family.
Wait, you know, speaking about Tefo's family, do we have a right to talk about some of the situations that they are undergoing right now, as of us speaking?
Oh, yes, most definitely. Look, we all know that Mr. Tefo has been an astute advocate who's been working very hard, and he saved a lot of people in the police force. But since he's been behind bars, there's no income, and the wife is unemployed. As a result, there are very, very serious problems, like at school, for example, since they haven't been paying school fees. There's a termination letter that she received where they terminated the contract. So in the coming next term, when the schools open, the kids will not be allowed to go to school. And there's also challenges of where they stay, even though I'm not going to give details in terms of what exactly is happening, but they are likely to lose their home as well. So for all those who are concerned, can we please understand that they we really need to assist where we can so that we can remedy the situation. We don't want a situation where they are kicked out and now they don't have a home. Already the kids when the schools open, they're not going to be allowed to go because they are owing. So that is why I'm actually trying my best to put in a structured campaign so that you can raise as much as possible to remedy the situation. Even the lawyer for that matter that I had spoken to, we do know that there had been some challenges in the past for some time. Advocate Defa had not been having legal representation, and because he's been depressed, he's been severely depressed, it was not possible that he could represent himself. Hence, we had to find a lawyer to represent him who actually wants funds as well. So, yeah, those are the challenges that we are facing.
You know, speaking about the funds, I feel like, Sis Lerato has already told us how much is the lawyer will charge daily. And I said to people, you know what, this for me is very reasonable, considering that I was speaking to some of the lawyers, and I'm not going to give people an idea as to which ones and where. But I was speaking to them, and they were telling me that they are charging somewhere between 10,000 to 15,000 rand a day, just to appear a day. And this lawyer is charging way, way, way reasonable for that matter. So people, when they understand how lawyers works, yo, some lawyers, they charge per hour, not a day. And you know that when a lawyer is, most of the time, by the way, they charge per hour, not per day. And you know, when a lawyer is charging you per day, that lawyer is very reasonable to those who know. And in the case of advocate, therefore, looking at the situation, there is no way advocate, therefore, can represent himself. There's no way.
Absolutely, Bongani, you are quite right. Even though I'm not at liberty to release the name of his legal representative, the rate that she is charging us is a negotiated rate. We pleaded with her. I pleaded with her, and made her aware as to the dire situation that Tefo is in. And she generously decided that no, she will actually assist in that regard and not charge us her usual rates. But all that being said, we must not just take for granted that no, because she's not charging as much as what others would charge, and therefore let's give a little. It's still substantive amount, because she still has to go to court a number of times for a number of other things that they've actually charged him with. Whether it's justifiable or not, it's another story altogether. So yes, the lawyer has given us very fair and reasonable rate, but it's still substantive.
You know what I will think? I will think that it would be nice if we. It would be nice if we make sure that we don't disappoint this lawyer. We make sure that her funds are paid on time.
You know, that is so important. In fact, to be honest, if I can just say this, I feel bad, because I spoke to this lawyer and I promised that, look, we will do everything possible to ensure that you get your money. And only to find that when I said that, she had to immediately start working on the matter. I had to, I'm sure Mrs. Steffo can tell you this, Bongani, I had to go out of my way to loan 3,000 rands from friends to pay this lawyer, which would still need to be paid at a later stage, just to show a commitment that we will be able to pay. Now, this week, she was a bit unhappy because she was going to see Tefo and there are no funds coming in. And please, if people can work hard to try and assist, because if we lose this lawyer, we'll be back to square one. And she knows what she's doing. It is promising. Advocate Tefo is in good hands. We will hear good results soon, provided we don't disappoint her as well.
Hey, speaking about the good results, I know it's just that for now it's not a right time for us to announce those things. But wow, I can't wait for that day. But I can see that day is coming. The day for good results. I can see just by the bit of briefing that I had, I was like, wow, okay. Surely there's good news here coming up. I can't wait for that. I can't wait for that.
Absolutely. There's a lot of good progress, because before we got this lawyer, things were not okay. Things were just upside down. There was no progress. Because of his depression, he's been trying to solve matters himself. And of course, he was not as articulate as he was, being in prison and having to think about his family and the crisis, and at the same time to fight for his release. So obviously, under the depressed state, he would make a lot of he wouldn't be as quite effective and make a lot of mistakes in the process. So there was no progress. But now there is a lot of progress. People must just tune in to Bongani's show and then just follow. There's good progress. Very soon you will be hearing good things about Advocate Tefo. We will have him out, definitely.
Only if we don't disappoint the lawyer.
If we don't disappoint the lawyer.
Tell me
if
something.
We don't.
Okay, continue.
Sure. Yeah. No, if we want to see our hero, Advocate Defo, out, let's make sure that we raise this money and donate so that we get the lawyer. If the lawyer goes or maybe doesn't get the money, we are the ones who would have failed to advocate Defo.
That's true. So tell me something. The way I'm hearing it, you are saying, you sounded like there is money that is not yet paid to the lawyer.
Yes. After I paid the 3,000 that I had to loan in order for the lawyer to get started, I had promised that we will raise money so that we can be able to pay her when she continues. Unfortunately, that hadn't been done as yet. So, because now there are people who donate, but unfortunately, to be honest with you, it's not just the lawyer's fees that we need. Mrs. Defo needs to feed her kids. There's a lot of other things that she then needs to take care of. Like if people will donate, others will donate 100 rand, others will donate 50 rand. So when that money comes in, she needs to pay electricity. Can she take that money and pay the lawyer? Absolutely not. So it is more or less that problem that the lawyer has not been getting the money, because people would be donating, but when the money gets home, there are urgent issues. There are urgent things that the money gets to be used on. This is why we are actually structuring this campaign to make it more effective, so that it can be able to cover the social needs of the family as well as the legal costs. So that's okay. Why the attorney hasn't been receiving the money. That's why we are pleading, please, to all justice-loving people and those that support to advocate. Therefore, we appreciate that you've been doing a lot to try and help. But can we spread the word and invite as many people as possible? Because this is not about Advocate Defo alone. It's a failure of our justice system. Today it can be me who's put in that situation. Today it can be you. So let's pray to make it more effective so that we can raise enough money to take care of the family as well as the lawyers. We need to be more proactive than just commenting on Bongani's platform. We need to go out there and talk to people. That's how serious the matter is. But if we can work together as a nation to ensure that Advocate Defo gets the kind of assistance that it needs, that he needs, we will get results, better results soon. So it all lies, the ball is in our court, basically. But we do appreciate for those that have been donating. It did make a big difference to the family. Izingane are able to eat, the kids are able to eat, the wife is able to pay for electricity and other needs. But we need to do a little bit more than that.
All right. No, I hear you. Currently, because Sis Lerato did say that Advocate Defo will be appearing on the 9th of October. So we currently don't have funds even for that. So from what I'm hearing is that let's make sure that before the 9th of October, we have money for that appearance as well as the previous appearance as well. So yeah, I think that's what I'm hearing, and I think that's what we should be doing going forward. But yeah, even the family themselves, the situation is a bit dire there, because like you are saying, good, sometimes, like from what I know right now, they don't have electricity. Those are some of the things that need to be covered as of us speaking. Yeah, I stand up again because the husband is not working and the wife hasn't found work yet.
Absolutely. But just to be more strategic and proactive for your viewers, to those I know amongst your viewers, we do have a couple of activists who can do more than just donating. Can we spread the word? Those that listen to radio, whatever radio station that you follow, I know there are programs where people can phone and raise whatever concern. Let's raise that. Let's push this so that the message can spread to more people. Because I can understand that we've got people who are kind-hearted and love UTEFO. But considering the high unemployment rate and the state of the economy, you know, people are struggling. So we need to go to a broader audience so that we don't deal with the people that are just following here, Bongani's platform, so that you can reach to the broader part of society. It would help. Sometimes you might not even have the money, but you can talk to people, you can talk to people, and then we grow, we expand in terms of reaching out to more people who can be able to assist. And then in that way, we can have better results, I would suggest.
No problem. I just want to, look, let's end it here. Thank you very much. We shall talk going forward. Your last words, please.
Thank you, Bongani. To everybody else who's assisting, just know that blessed is the hand that gives. May God bless everybody else that has been useful in assisting this campaign going forward. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Bongani. Bye.